What up, guys? Mass Thin Chill coming at you live and loud with another movie review for you guys today. And today we are looking at Gotham by Gaslight. This movie was pretty good, actually. I really did enjoy the story. All around, the light changes that they did to the graphic novel. Honestly, I actually have never seen the never read the graphic novel, so. All around, it was a nice little mystery trying to figure out who is Jack the Ripper. And I'm not going to ruin it for you, so you're going to have to watch it. Because it's actually very good. I really enjoyed the take on the Batman's mythos. Kind of blend with the 19th century Gotham. Like, yeah, it was a steampunk, but still had that 19th century feel. It was like a nice blend. Personally, I really enjoy watching the Batman villains not being villains. I mean, Poison Ivy, Catwoman, and Doctor Strange all showed up. And also Harvey Dent. And all that. It was actually pretty decent. I did not mistake. It was a good movie. Just the grounds that it was a good mystery watching it unfold, watching how everything looked. I mean, honestly, it was great seeing all three Robins actually together in one scene without them not really being Robins, I guess. As we had Jason. We have Dick, Jason, and Todd, all three together. So, yeah, it's not bad. So, would I recommend Gotham by Gaslight? Yes. But, here's a warning. It is R-rated, so you little kiddies, you might need your parents' permission to watch it. But with that said, would I recommend it? Hell yes, go right ahead. And if you guys like to have my opinion on any of the DC Universe movies, leave them down in the comments below. I would love to talk about more of these movies. So with that said, this is the Masked Ninja signing off. Until next time, peace.